Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Amy from Rebel Nutrition, and if you're new around here, I make all different types of skincare, beauty, makeup, and skin treatment videos. So before I go on, make sure to hit the red subscribe button below if you haven't already. And today's video is gonna be so much fun because I recently did a huge Sephora haul, and I actually don't go there that often. So when I do go, I buy a lot of stuff, okay? So I'm gonna start first with the two skincare products that I purchased that I have actually purchased multiple times before, so I can tell you guys with full certainty that I absolutely love both of these products and I will continue to buy them until the end of time. Okay, first things first, you guys know how obsessed I am with protecting my skin from hyperpigmentation, dark spots, and melasma, so it makes sense that the first thing that I'm going to share with you guys is this Peter Thomas Roth SPF 45 Hyaluronic Acid Cloud Moisturizer with SPF. So I absolutely love this. I use this before I put on makeup and it just gives your skin like the dewiest, glowiest look. I'm wearing it right now under the makeup that I have on. And best of all, it doesn't look greasy and it also gives you SPF. So I like to like double layer my SPF just to make sure I'm protected. And I absolutely love this. And I love the fact that it doesn't give you like a sunscreeny feel under your makeup because that's not what I'm looking for, especially if I'm layering makeup on top. So highly recommend that. I've bought it many times before and I will continue to do so. All right, product number two on the same topic of preventing melasma, dark spots, hyperpigmentation, is the Drunk Elephant C-Firma Day Serum. So this is a 15% L-ascorbic acid vitamin C serum. I've bought this many times before and I'm not gonna lie, it is on the pricier side. I think it's like $80 for this tube, but it does last you a while and it's honestly the best quality vitamin C serum that I've found besides the SkinCeuticals one. And the SkinCeuticals one, you guys, is like $160. So I feel like I don't know if I necessarily want to spend $160 on one item. So I feel like it's a happy medium going with the Drunk Elephant versus the SkinCeuticals. However, when I was at Sephora, I realized that there are quite a few other vitamin C serums that I'm very intrigued by, and they are all pretty pricey. So if you guys have one that you love that I should try next, please let me know in the comments because I love a vitamin C serum. And then one thing I will say about this too is make sure you keep it in the refrigerator because the vitamin C, you'll notice after a while, if you don't keep it in the refrigerator, it'll turn kind of like a brown color, sort of like when you have a citrus fruit that goes rotten and it gets brown. Well, if you keep it in the refrigerator, it stays fresh and it stays like active longer. So I love the little pink mini fridge and I keep all my skincare in there. It's the best, okay? So those are the two skincare products that I bought. Everything else pretty much is makeup and I'm really excited because I'm actually not a huge makeup person. So the stuff that I'm showing you guys today is like the best of the best. If you're going to be a minimalist makeup person, these are the things that you need, okay? So first, let me show you this new CC cream. It's the IT Cosmetics CC Cream SPF 50, color correcting full coverage cream plus anti-aging hydrating serum. I have heard so many good things over time about IT Cosmetics and I honestly was really turned off by the packaging. I am such an aesthetic person. Like I'm really drawn to certain brands by their packaging. And to me, the IT Cosmetics, I'm sorry if you're from IT Cosmetics, but I thought it looked very like drugstore brand-y. So I always never wanted to buy it. I know that sounds like so superficial, but I am in love with this, okay? The coverage is amazing, especially if you are somebody who has, you know, dark spots, hyperpigmentation, melasma like I do that I'm trying to get rid of. I mean, look at how full coverage this is. I can do like a before and after shot for you guys so you can see just the full extent of this, but it's amazing. This is the foundation that I was using previously, which is the Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Filter. Don't get me wrong, I love the Flawless Filter. I am a Charlotte Tilbury stan, but when I kind of noticed the difference between this one and that one in terms of coverage, I was like, I don't know if I'm gonna buy this one anymore, honestly. I think if you're somebody who has, you know, really great skin to begin with, and all you need is just like a little bit of dewiness and a little bit of coverage, this one would be good for you. But if you need more coverage, I would definitely recommend this one instead. Next up, one of the most common questions I get from people is about my under eyes. So I get a lot of questions about if I've done like under eye filler and what I do to like basically have no lines and no puffiness or creases or anything below my under eyes. So let me be completely transparent with you. I have not done under eye filler. Under eye filler does scare me a little bit, I'm gonna be honest, but I have had Botox underneath my eye. So if you're going to somebody who really knows what they're doing, they can do just like a little droplet underneath your eye so that it doesn't look weird when you smile, but it does prevent that creasing from happening. So that's what I would say number one, if you want to prevent like creasing under eye. But other than that, in terms of makeup, this is definitely the best under eye concealer that I've ever found. And this is the Creaseless Concealer from Tarte. What I've also noticed to make this look even better, I just dab like a couple dots underneath my eye, up on my cheekbone, and then this is the key, you guys. Rather than just patting it in with your finger or even using a beauty blender, what I think works even better to kind of smooth it out is to use a little concealer brush. So this is actually the Tarte Cosmetics concealer brush, and I just use this small end, and I literally like just so gently tap it out, and it looks way more natural. You're not gonna have streaks, you're not gonna have creases. And the combination of these two things is just the best for under eyes that look nice and smooth like this. Okay, the next thing that I purchased from Sephora is another Charlotte Tilbury. I have been a huge Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish fan forever. However, just like the Flawless Filter, so this is like the liquid Flawless Filter, and this is called the Airbrush Flawless Filter. Like, this is a powder, obviously, and this is a liquid. Neither one of these is super heavy coverage, but I found that I actually really like light coverage for powder so it doesn't look cakey, and I'd have like more coverage with the liquid and then put this on top to just kind of set it. So this powder foundation, I just lightly dab over the CC cream and over my eyes where I did the under eye concealer. And it just gives kind of like, it just mattifies your face a little bit so you're not like looking too greasy, but you still have a little bit of dew. And it doesn't deposit too much color because again, like I don't wanna be super cakey, but that is my favorite. I've tried a lot of other pressed powders and they either don't cover enough or they're way too thick. So I absolutely love that one. And I've actually purchased that one multiple times before. So I probably will continue to do so. Taking a quick break from this video to tell you guys how I've been making 6 figures a month since the beginning of this year online. And I know that sounds crazy. I simply turned my passion for wellness into an online course that sells passively and helps hundreds of women every single day. In my free masterclass, I'll be sharing how you can turn your passion into a passive online course business and my step-by-step method for getting started with your own online course, even if you're like, WTF would I even teach? To join the free masterclass, click the first link in the description box right below this video. Don't forget, it's free, and I'll see you there. Okay, back to the video. All right, next, let's go to the brows. I'm obsessed with eyebrows, you guys. I got my eyebrows microbladed a couple years ago and it changed the shape of my face. I've talked about this a lot, but it was honestly like one of the best beauty things besides Botox that I've ever done. So even though my eyebrows are microbladed, I do still fill them in a little bit just to make them a little bit more perfect. And what I've found to be my absolute favorite way to fill them in is actually not pencil, because I don't think that looks super natural. And then the eyebrow gels that, you know, it's kind of like mascara that you just kind of comb in, I feel like don't really do anything for the shape. So in terms of reshaping and making your eyebrows look perfect, I love this Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Powder Duo. So it gives you like a lighter color and a darker color. Obviously you can see that I've used this a little bit. And then it also gives you this tool so that you can be really precise with the strokes that you're doing on your eyebrows. And then you can also like brush them up when they're done. So I absolutely love this. I think it's the best. It's really the only eyebrow pencil like color that you need, in my opinion. And it does take a little bit of time to like learn how to get your eyebrows looking perfect, I found, and microblading does help a lot with that, but just keep practicing, you'll get it. And I have another makeup video tutorial coming soon where I kind of show you guys how I do my eyebrows, but if you would like a full eyebrow tutorial, give this video a thumbs up, let me know in the comments, and I will make that for you. Okay, one more thing though I have to say about the eyebrows. This is actually not from Sephora, but it is so on trend right now to brush your eyebrows up. So I don't like to look super crazy, but I do like to brush each of the strands up a little bit. I think it's really youthful. It kind of opens your face a little bit. And my favorite brow gel is actually from Beauty Counter. And I love this one. This is just the clear one. And so I do it after I draw my eyebrows on. I just kind of like brush them up and it helps them stick. But the Anastasia one and the other, there's a couple other ones that I've tried, just the clear brow gel, just make your eyebrows feel too, it's like too thick or too hairspray-like, and it kind of itches my face, to be honest. This keeps them in place, but is really natural feeling. It's not crispy. Yes, that's the word I was looking for, crispy. We don't want crispy eyebrows. Okay, next, let's talk about highlighter. So I'm actually wearing the highlighter I'm about to show you. I'm wearing it a little bit right here. I have it down the bridge of my nose, my forehead, my chin. Highlighter is my favorite. It's my favorite way to like accentuate certain features. However, I went looking for the Becca highlighter in Champagne Pop. It is like my favorite highlighter. I've used it for years. And when I got to Sephora, they said that Becca went out of business. And that is really sad. So I asked around, luckily the people there were very helpful. I asked for a highlighter that was similar to the Becca one that I was looking for. And this is what I got. The brand is called, I don't know how to say it, but it looks like Jouer. Jouer. But it is beautiful. I picked the color Skinny Dip and it's really pigmented. You can't really see it too much here, but it's a little bit more on like the pink bronzy side. It's a little bit warmer. It's not quite as yellow as some highlighters are, and I don't love yellow or even a yellow hint. So I'm really obsessed with this one. I actually have been using it as highlighter. I've been using it as eyeshadow and I love it. It's even cheaper than the Becca one too, which is really great. So I will probably continue to buy this one as well. You know, another thing that bugged me about the Becca one too is that it always would crack. And I don't know if I was just being really rough on my products, but it would always crack. And so I would always waste like half of the thing. So hopefully this one doesn't. All right, next let's talk about mascara. So another thing that I went to Sephora to find to repurchase because I'm in love with it is this Marc Jacobs mascara. I've been using this mascara for probably 3 years. Absolutely love it. It works so well, but they were out of it. I asked again, a very helpful Sephora employee, and they told me that the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara, which is a great name, they said that this was the most similar to the Marc Jacobs one. So to be honest, you guys, I actually just used this mascara for the first time this morning. Here's the up close. And I really like it. I will let you know if I think it's as good as the Marc Jacobs one, but I will say if you can still get the Marc Jacobs one, like even maybe online or at the Sephora store near you, I would probably still get that one. And I think it was even on sale for like $14. It's normally like $27. This I bought for full price and it was like 28. So I would recommend the Marc Jacobs one, but I'm gonna try this one a couple more times and let you guys know what I think. All right, last but not least, because I will probably get a question on this, the lip color that I am wearing that I am obsessed with, obviously, usually for me, I feel like it needs to be like a little bit of a special occasion to wear red lipstick. It's really good for fall and the holidays. I mean, I honestly wear red lips year round just for like special occasions. I feel like this color is universally flattering probably on anyone because it's not too deep and it's not too orange. It's like the perfect color red. It's actually a combination of two products though, and they are both Charlotte Tilbury. But the first one is the Lip Cheat from Charlotte Tilbury and the color is Savage Rose. So I use this to just line my lips and be like kind of more precise with how I do them. And then I put the lipstick on top. So this is just the lipstick from Charlotte Tilbury. And the color is Red Carpet Red. So if you've been somebody who's tried to do like a deep red lip and it's never really come out how you wanted it to before, I really think the key is using the liner to kind of like set the foundation and then the lipstick on top. And honestly, like I will do this and it'll last really well for like 4 or 5 hours, even if I'm eating. So it's really great if you're gonna like go do something all day long and you wanna have a lipstick that stays all day. Highly recommend. I will definitely also continue to buy these two things because they look great and they're easy to use and it turns out good. All right, you guys, that is my summer Sephora haul. I hope you loved it. Again, I'm going to link everything that I purchased down below. And again, tell me in the comments, because I need to know if you stay till the end, what vitamin C serum you guys are using. Should I stick with Drunk Elephant? Should I try another one? Is the SkinCeuticals one worth $160? I don't know, but you're gonna need to tell me, okay? Because we have dark spots that we are trying to get rid of. And again, if you are somebody who also struggles with dark spots, melasma, hyperpigmentation, be sure to subscribe. I have a lot of videos like that in the works coming, and I also try a lot of different skincare treatments for you guys to let you know my honest opinion. All right, I will be back soon with another video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Mwah.